Ever thought you could make a real working soldering iron using just a spark plug and a battery? Sounds crazy, right? Let's start by loosening the spark plug. Use a pair of pliers and twist it gently until the metal head separates. We'll need this space later to mount our graphite core. Next, grab a regular AA battery, the kind you probably have lying around in a drawer. Use a utility knife to carefully cut around the metal casing. Once you open it up, you'll find a dark rod in the center that's the graphite core. It's fragile, so take your time and avoid bending or cracking it. This little piece will act as the heating tip for our homemade soldering tool. Amazing, isn't it? Something this simple can handle real metalwork once we're done building. I'm curious, where are you watching from today? Drop your city or country down below, I'd love to know. Now that we've got our graphite rod, it's time to give it a sharp point. Slide it into your drill chuck just like a drill bit. Turn the drill on at low speed and gently press the tip against a piece of sandpaper. Move slowly until it forms a nice fine point. This sharp edge will help our soldering iron heat up and focus energy exactly where we need it. Here's the part that gives our homemade soldering setup its extra punch, the electrolyte solution. Grab the metal casing you peeled off from the battery earlier and cut it into small pieces. Drop those into a glass or plastic cup. Now carefully pour in a bit of hydrochloric acid, just enough to cover the metal. You'll see tiny bubbles forming almost right away. That's the acid reacting with the zinc. This reaction creates a simple electrolyte solution that helps current flow more efficiently during soldering. If you don't have hydrochloric acid, you can also use vinegar. It's weaker, but it still does the job. Give it a few minutes to react and your homemade solution is ready to go. Now let's bring everything together and turn these simple parts into a real working tool. Take your old spark plug, the base will act as the handle and support. Gently insert the graphite rod right into the ceramic top of the plug. If it feels loose, wrap a bit of copper wire around it and tighten it with pliers. This will help the graphite stay snug and conduct heat evenly when current flows through. Next, grab two short electrical wires with alligator clips at the ends. Strip a bit of insulation from the other side so the copper is exposed. One wire will connect to the metal body of the spark plug. This will serve as the negative terminal. The other wire connects directly to the graphite tip. This is your positive terminal. Secure both wires firmly with electrical tape so nothing comes loose while you're working. What you've just built is the core of your homemade soldering iron, sturdy, efficient, and ready to handle small welding or soldering jobs. Not bad for a few leftover parts, right? Now it's time to power this homemade soldering iron. Take a standard drill battery. These packs deliver strong, steady current, perfect for small welding work. Use two washers or metal rings to touch the positive and negative terminals of the battery. Then attach your alligator clips, the red one to the positive side and the black one to the negative. Make sure the connections are tight so you don't lose any power. Once it's hooked up, you're basically ready to weld. The spark plug and graphite rod will heat up quickly, so handle it carefully. In just seconds, you've got a functional portable soldering tool powered by a simple drill battery. All right, now for the moment of truth. Let's see how well this homemade soldering setup performs. I'll start with something simple, two razor blades. Touch the graphite tip right where the edges meet. You'll see a small spark that's the current heating the metal instantly. Hold it steady for a few seconds, and when you pull away, look at that. The blades are fused together tight. Next, let's try soldering a small stainless steel bracket. At first, you might notice the solder doesn't stick well to the metal. That's normal, stainless steel can be tricky. So here's the trick. Dip a cotton swab into the electrolyte solution we made earlier and dab just a little on the welding spot. Try soldering again, this time it grabs beautifully. The joint is solid and shiny. Not bad at all for a tool made from nothing, but an old spark plug, a few wires, and a battery. It's proof that creativity can turn everyday parts into something truly useful. And there you have it, a simple yet powerful homemade soldering tool built from just a spark plug, a few batteries, and a bit of ingenuity. It's strong enough to weld metal and compact enough to use anywhere. That's the beauty of DIY, turning everyday items into something practical and clever. If you enjoyed this project, let me know in the comments. Just type spark so I know you made it to the end. Thanks for watching, my friends. Stay creative, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.